Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss what will happen if you don't wash your biodiesel that you have produced, or if you are using the unwashed biodiesel. See, the governing standards that you buy is ASTM D6751 or EU standards. Now, various impurities that can come into picture are if there is an incomplete reaction, then there will be presence of mono, di, and triglycerides in your biodiesel. The second one will be free glycerol that you are that is present in your biodiesel, even if it gravity settlement has been done, but then also traces of free glycerol are present. Residual alcohol, in case the producer has not recovered methanol completely from the biodiesel produced, then this residual alcohol will be present. Residual catalyst, if excess catalyst was there which didn't took part in the reaction, so it will be present in your biodiesel. And the most common impurity will be moisture, that is water or sediments. So let's take one by one how these are going to affect your engine performance or car performance. Now the first point is, what if the reaction was not complete at the time of transesterification? High in triglycerides present in your biodiesel. The presence of these unreacted oil components can be done with a test that is known as 27x3 test. It can be performed at site also. It is not very equipment demanding. Now the standard that we have already discussed, that ASTM standard, demands the presence of glycerol to be within 0.25%. That is the limit given by the standard. It should not cross that limit. Otherwise, engine is going to face while running your biodiesel. Triglycerides can be removed with water washing. If these are not removed, then specific fuel consumption of your and power definitely going to get affected. Your valve clearance will also reduce, and over a period of time you'll observe black smoke coming out of your exhaust pipes. The second one is free glycerol. In a standard process, this free glycerol is removed first by settlement, that is gravity settlement, and then water washing is required to remove the traces of glycerol from the biodiesel that you are going to use in your vehicle. Certain people think that distillation is going to take care of glycerols, but generally it is observed that if a person is doing distillation of biodiesel, then percentage of glycerol has increased because bottom of the distillation tower. Definitely it is going to have a percentage of glycerol, but most of the glycerol will be carried over with the biodiesel itself. So you are going to get a higher ppm level of glycerol in your final biodiesel. The effect of this excess glycerin or glycerol is, with a period of time, it starts settling in your engine tank, fuel tank, and due to this deposition, it can block the plugs, it can plug the filters and create combustion problems. Residual alcohol and residual catalyst. The alcohol level should be very low in your biodiesel. That means methanol should be reduced as much as possible. There's a reason behind it. The reason is, even if there is a 1% methanol in your biodiesel, that can lower the flash point from 170 degree, which is typically for biodiesel. It can reduce that to 40 degree Celsius, and then it comes and then your fuel will come under class A classification of combustible fuels. So even a 1% methanol present in your biodiesel is going to change the category of your fuel. The handling procedure will change because the lower the flash point, the easily it catches fire. So you have to handle it as like petrol. Now, as limit given to it that this much should be your methanol content in the biodiesel, but indirectly, what they are what ASTM has said that the biodiesel that is produced should have a minimum of flash point that will be 130 degrees Celsius. So indirectly, they have given the indication that your biodiesel, whatever biodiesel you are going to produce, should have minimum methanol level. Traces of methanol can be removed by or methanol recovery units are available in market that can be utilized. Those are basically recovery units running under back biodiesel to 70-75 degrees Celsius with agitation and the methanol after condensation. The residual catalyst is present in biodiesel in the form of suspended particles. The gives for its limit is sulfated ash, and whatever ash content that is left after complete combustion, that is known as sulfated ash value for that fuel. Excess of sulfated ash can lead to engine deposits. This is the end effect. There will be deposits on your engine cylinder as well as piston, and that will lead to, definitely it is going to lead to high abrasive wear and tears to the cylinder as well as piston. Water and sediments. Generally, water doesn't come in biodiesel from the process. It is basically housekeeping or basically. Water can be present in biodiesel in two forms, either in dissolved form or in suspended water droplets. Biodiesel have water in the range of 1500 ppm, whereas the diesel that we are using currently in our diesel engines takes up to 50 ppm. Generally, that is the range. This in your biodiesel to 500 ppm level. The end effect of presence of water in your biodiesel is it will affect your fuel injection equipment that is going to definitely corrode the system. So corrosion is a major issue. And suspended rust can cause filter choking. See, the biodiesel is a good solvent. It is definitely going to clean up your tank if you are straightway using biodiesel. Earlier you were using diesel. So just because of that particular property, it is going to scavenge all the dirt and dust particles that are present in tank and fuel system, and it will carry it with itself to the engine. So prior entering engine, there is a filter. It is going to choke that. So these are the few sediments, few impurities that can be present in your biodiesel. So before using any biodiesel, kindly get it checked that it is meeting all the parameters of ASTM standards. Biodiesel should be worst at all costs, should not be used straight after transesterification and then gravity separation, whatever standard practice that is going on today in biodiesel industry. People are making the biodiesel just by looking at YouTube videos or whatever information is available. You should not do that. The standard procedure has to be followed, and the biodiesel produced has to meet ASTM standard. Then only your engine is going to run smoothly. Otherwise, at any instance, it can stop working, and you are stuck midway with no possible solution. So thank you, and for any requirement, please contact us on below mentioned address. Or contact details. Thank you.